Hey everyone, welcome back. So today's video is another drugstore dupes video, but it's on a single product and it's another Makeup Revolution palette actually. This is called the Makeup Revolution Radiance palette. And I found this at Ulta because they are the exclusive retailer for Makeup Revolution in the United States. And I was really curious because I think some of the best products that this brand makes are their highlighters. And this is basically a palette of three what look to be highlighters. And when I was looking at them, I started thinking these look very similar to the Hourglass ambient powders. And I'm pretty sure that's what they're trying to do. They're trying to give you a dupe to that. And so I definitely had to bring this home and compare it because I do own the Hourglass ambient powder palette, which is sold exclusively at Sephora. This thing is expensive. It's, I think, $62. And if there is something that is equally good at the drugstore, I would in a heartbeat switch out. So today's video is devoted to comparing these two and telling you my experience after using both of these for a little while. These are meant to be more on the subtle side of highlighters. Actually, the Hourglass is meant to be more of a collection of finishing powders that you could also use as very mild highlighters, but they are marketed as finishing powders. This one actually says highlighter palette on it, so they are not saying it's a finishing powder, but I have to tell you after looking at both, they are very comparable. Throughout this video, I am wearing the Makeup Revolution on the right side of my face and the Hourglass on the left. The Hourglass palette comes with the three powders. Two of them are part of the permanent line, and then the middle shade is actually a limited edition to the palette. So I believe this beige tone one is called Dim Light, and then the bronzy warmer tone is called Radiant Light. The limited edition shade is Incandescent Light. I actually use Dim Light today as a setting powder all over my face and even under my eyes. And I love the way it works as a setting powder because it doesn't really mess with the finish of whatever foundation you're wearing. It gives a really pretty soft focus effect. I love it under the eye area because it doesn't make the area look drier, but it does help set the concealer. The other one, Radiant Light, I actually use kind of as a bronzer. So I have it on my cheeks and around my hairline. It's very mild, but it does give some warmth to the skin and some luminosity, although it doesn't have any shimmer in it. By no means looks like a highlight on me. It just gives kind of a lit from within look, which is really what they're going for with these powders. And I love their texture. I love how airy they are, how they apply to the skin, and how they wear throughout the day. They're not ones that I would go to for oil control, but they do couple nicely if you want to apply a more oil controlling powder and then this on top to give a little more radiance. They do wear really nicely. The middle shade, Incandescence, is a very soft, almost like a pearl highlight. It looks really pretty and it's one that works beautifully for daylight because you can barely tell it's there. I'm sure you can't even see it on camera. But it is very natural and it still gives you a little bit of a glow, which I really love. Now, bringing in the Makeup Revolution palette, when I hold these side by side, I think that they look very similar. But I will tell you, if you look closely at these powders, even before applying them to your skin, the Makeup Revolution has a little bit more sheen to them, shimmer without being glittery. They are just stunning looking at them in the pan, but I don't think that they are exact dupes for this type of texture. These ones are a little bit more creamy and pigmented. And I would say that all three of these colors are gonna give you more luminosity and could probably be used for highlighters. I ended up using the middle shade so that I could keep it comparable with the Hourglass as my highlighter on the right side. And I think this one is definitely more noticeable, but still subtle compared to a lot of highlighters on the market. Like, this isn't gonna be a Mary Luminizer. It's not gonna be something that you see from 10 feet away, but it gives you still a really beautiful highlight. The other two powders in here, I find to be, again, more pigmented and to have a little bit more sheen or shimmer to them than the Hourglass. But of the three in here, I think that the beige tone, which is most comparable to the Dim Light in the Hourglass palette, I think that these two are the most similar. because of the three colors in the Makeup Revolution, this one has the least amount of shimmer on the skin. And I did use it as my under eye setting powder and also to set the other half of my face. And this one, again, I used to put some warmth on my cheeks and around my hairline. And I liked the color that this one gave a little bit more because it was a little more pronounced. I think that this would be a beautiful highlight on tan to deeper skin tones as well. Overall, the quality of these powders is amazing. I mean, not just for drugstore. I think that the texture, the way they apply, the way they wear is comparable to a lot of high-end highlighters. And in terms of how they compare to the Hourglass, would I say they are exact dupes? No, but I think they are really close. And if you want a little bit more effect on your skin than you might get with the Hourglass, this is definitely worth checking out. In fact, I would say between these two, I would pick this one in a heartbeat. I just like that I get a little bit more bang for my buck. I get a little bit more pigmentation and a little bit more sheen on the skin. The price point is incredible. This is $15 compared to $62. You're getting twice as much product in here. I believe this comes with 15 grams. And this only comes with 3.3 grams. So it's almost three times as much product. Definitely a thumbs up from me. I highly recommend checking this out if you're looking for some beautiful, more subtle highlighters. So hopefully this review was helpful, especially if you've been eyeing this palette and wondering about it, or maybe you didn't even know it was out there because it is fairly new. Now you have the information, and if you have any other questions that I might have forgotten to answer in this video, please feel free to let me know in the comments section. I do my very best to respond to as many of you as possible. And if you're new to my channel, please feel free to subscribe to continue to get videos from me. Thank you all for joining me today, and I hope you have a really good weekend. I will talk to you all very soon. Bye-bye.